Using this information, we can also infer how this AML was developed or evolved over time and created this clonal architecture. We collaborated in a group in Switzerland to use this site algorithm to infer the clonal evolution model. And most of the cases we analyzed ended up having this type of linear acquisition model, but some cases showed this divergent structure where after the acquiring one mutation, there was a separate independent branch acquiring several mutations. This case really represents this divergent and convergent evolution pattern, which is really fascinating. But after acquiring this NPM1 mutation, this clone decided to separate into two different branches, but each branch acquired IDH1 and IDH2 mutation independently. And again, these two branches independently started to acquire KRAS, PTPN11, NRAS, and another NRAS mutation. So as a result, this tumor had 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 independent clones, but all these individual clones had some sort of shared functionality because they are combined with this NPM1 alteration or IDH alteration plus RAS alteration. So this really resembled this divergent evolution and convergent evolution that is observed in our biology too, which really supports that cancer cell also has this Darwinian selection mechanism to create their clonal architecture.